Good morning. These are JAT 2020 preparations. Exams are held in the month of January. And this we are taking the chapter Simple Equation in the Quantitative Aptitude. This is also the one of the important chapters this year that will come in the JAT examinations. Question like that. A and B have the 28 rupees each. We have taken the A and B. A rupees 28 and B has also rupees 28. Both have the money in the denomination rupees 5, 1 and 50 paise coins. Each has at least 1 coin of each denomination. This is 1 coin of each denomination. If A and B have the maximum minimum possible value number of coins respectively with them, then how many coins more than B does A have? So here we are taking A has the maximum number of coins. Maximum number of coins and the B has the minimum number of coins. And coins in the denomination of rupees 5, rupees 1 and 50 paise. If A has the maximum, so this is the minimum. This is also the minimum. And this 50 paise will be the maximum. This is the condition we are following when we have to find out the maximum number of coins. So here, rupees 5. So here the 1 coins, whose value will be rupees 5. Here again the 1 coin, whose value will be rupees 1. So here 5 plus 1 is 6. So 28 minus 6 is the 22. So remaining 22 rupees contain with the 50 paise coins. So 50 paise coins. Of total rupees 22, so the 44 coins. So on that condition, A has the total number of coins, total coins equal to 1 plus 1 plus 44. So these are 46 coins that A has. Now B has again coins in the same denomination, rupees 5, rupees 1 and 50 paise, but in the minimum number of coins. So this is the maximum, this value is the maximum. So maximum then in terms of 5 coins are 25. On that condition, maximum he can take the 5 coins whose value will be rupees 25. Here maximum, so 28 minus 25 is the 3 rupees, but this cannot be 3 rupees because 50 paise also contains certain number of coins. So here the maximum 2 coins of rupees 1 whose value will be rupees 2, and this is the minimum. On that conditions, remaining 1 rupees, 25 plus 2 27, 28 minus 27 1, so rupees 1, so 2 coins. So total number of coins here, with B, is the 5 plus 2 plus 2 equal to 9. So we have to find out the difference between these two coins. So if you take the difference between these two coins, so there are 37 coins. So A has 37 coins more than that of B. So answer will be this one. So there is a question related to simple equation. Second question related to linear equation. If you see the linear equation of one variable, linear equation of one variable, highest power of the variables will be 1. So suppose that we have the two equations, a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0. This is the equation 1. And a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. This is the equation 2. If there are two simultaneous linear equations are there, on that condition, three conditions are following: infinite number of solution, no solution, and the unique solution. Here we have to find out the unique solution. So for a unique solution, a1 by a is not equal to b1 by b2. This is the system we are following. This is the equation we are following in the linear equation when we are solving the unique solution. Here, if you find out this equation, so a1 equal to 3, here a2 equal to k, here
d1 equal to 5 and b2 equal to minus 4. So simply we are putting here. So 3 by k is not equal to 5 by minus 4. This implies that k is not equal to cross multiplying minus 12 by 5. Therefore, k is not equal to minus 2.4.
So actually we are finding that k should not be equal to 2.4. If the k is equal to 2.4, so we are not getting the unique solution. So here we can say that any value of k except 2.4,
any value of k except 2.4 is the answer.
So this is the condition. We have to follow the condition whether the unique solution, infinite number solution or no solution. So in the unique solution, we have to put the value of k not equal to 2.4 and in any condition, and we will get the unique solution. Unique solution means exactly one solution. Hope that you like this video. Please subscribe it. You will get some more video in the coming future. Thank you very much.